On the other hand, the real property owners face a legal quagmire as they attempt to unwind the fraudulent sale of their land, which in some instances occurred years prior and with significant investment by the unwitting buyer in the meantime. Title companies have started picking up on the scams, but when they push back, the bad actors change tactics. They have started employing money mules. I've talked about that in videos before. If wire transfers are rejected because the property owner's name doesn't match the bank accounts, scammers use domestically based accomplices to set up limited liability companies. We are doing a lot of outreach with the industry here in New Jersey. They're very interested in learning more so that they don't fall victim to these scammers. As more realtors, title companies, and other groups along with the chain are becoming aware of the fraud and taking steps to stop it, criminals are shifting their attention. We're now seeing this evolve to abandoned properties and real rental homes.